Cryptocurrency. Now, this is a word that most people hear every single day. And even if they don't really know what it means, when they hear this word, they may think of Bitcoin, Ethereum, or perhaps just computers doing some magical things that very few people really understand. Regardless of what people think or believe, blockchain technology is now affecting people's lives across the globe. And there's been more and more pushing of blockchain technology into not only new crypto projects, but there's also been a move now into the government space and also the world's largest corporations. This is where we're likely to see the biggest surge of new people coming into the blockchain space. Consider for a moment, there are about 7.1 million active users of Bitcoin right now. This is about the population of the great state of Arizona. But Facebook and the companies it owns have about 2.4 billion monthly users. Now consider for a moment, if there were a currency that these 2.4 billion people had access to, where they could do commerce across borders and have little to no contact with their respective country's fiat currency. Let's take a close look at Facebook's own blockchain project called Libra. Before we jump into the interesting details about Facebook's blockchain project, we must first define some terms. The first one of these terms is digital assets. A digital asset is any text or media that is formatted into a binary source that includes the right to use it. Digital files that do not include this right are not considered digital assets. Digital assets are categorized into images and multimedia called media assets and textual content. This is opposed to what we call a cryptocurrency. A cryptocurrency is a digital or virtual currency that uses cryptography for security. A cryptocurrency is difficult to counterfeit because of this security feature. Many cryptocurrencies are decentralized systems based on blockchain technology, a distributed ledger enforced by a disparate network of computers, a defining feature of a cryptocurrency, and arguably its biggest allure is its organic nature. It is not issued by any central authority, rendering it theoretically immune to government interference or manipulation. Now, the reason I bring this up is the words cryptocurrency and digital assets are used interchangeably by many people across the globe. And for what we'll be talking about, it's important to know the difference. The two main things we will be focusing on are security and also decentralization. Now, when it comes to security, it's not that a digital asset is necessarily going to be more secure than a cryptocurrency, or less for that matter. But what is true is that a true cryptocurrency typically can keep the identity of those using it private. Now, when it comes to digital assets, this is not necessarily the case, nor is it the main objective. The other thing to consider is that if you're looking at a digital asset, in this case Libra, the currency is hardly decentralized. Now, it is not totally in the hands of Facebook, which you will discuss more later in the video, but it's not like Bitcoin or any other cryptocurrency that people are using to trade today, where this is a full decentralization of the authority. Also, with Bitcoin, you can buy and sell Bitcoin or buy and sell goods and services with Bitcoin and keep your identity from anyone who wants to know who you are. With Libra, at some stage, your identity will be revealed. It's important for people to recognize these differences as people need to know what it is they're getting into and if they're going to be protected and where they may be vulnerable. So before we actually jump into how Libra works, let's take a deeper dive into what objectives there are for the team over at Libra. Now, if you've never read a white paper before, what you usually find is somewhere near the beginning of the document, the authors will put to you a problem or a series of issues that they hope to solve. Now, Libra calls these their opportunity. Number one, we believe that many more people should have access to financial services and to cheap capital. Number two, we believe that people have an inherent right to control the fruit of their legal labor. Number three, we believe that global, open, instant, and low-cost movement of money will create immense economic opportunity and more commerce across the world. Number four, we believe that people will increasingly trust decentralized forms of governance. Number five, we believe that global currency and financial infrastructure should be designed and governed as a public good. Number six, that we all have a responsibility to help advance financial inclusion, support ethical actors, and continuously uphold the integrity of the ecosystem. That all seems pretty decent and also straightforward enough. And at the very least, they are ambitious problems to want to tackle. Now, can a single company create a world where everyone has control of the fruits of their legal labor? Probably not. But it may help a lot for people who are not quite there yet, and also point more people in the right direction. Let's take a closer look at each of these objectives by Libra. Number one, we believe that many more people should have access to financial services and to cheap capital. This is something that can be helped by Libra. Now consider for a moment you were a poor farmer, let's say in East Africa, and you wanted an easy, or at least easier, way to sell your goods to people in foreign lands. And you also wanted to bring new investors on board. If you're using Libra, and so are your trading partners, you should be able to accomplish your goal. Number two, we believe that people have an inherent right to control the fruit of their legal labor. This point's a little ambiguous than the first one. What the people at Libra probably intend to do is set up systems where people, no matter what their job is, can be paid in Libra. This is all good in theory, but there's no guarantee the employees of the world will be using Libra. And also, one has to remember that when you convert your money from Libra back into a fiat currency, there is nothing stopping an employer in some parts of the world taking part of the income back from the workers. Number three, we believe that global, open, instant, and low-cost movement of money will create immense economic opportunity and more commerce across the world. This is where they will probably win big time. Now, one of the things that makes distributed ledger technology-based systems so far superior to those of normal banks is when it comes to making payments. If it's on a speedy network like Ripple, you can process a few thousand transactions per second. With a bank, some transactions can take days to complete. Number four, we believe that people will increasingly trust decentralized forms of government. Now, this point is very true, but it is a little bit sneaky. Libra is not actually decentralized or as decentralized as some people would like to believe, but we will come back to these details when we discuss how the platform actually functions. It is true that people are finding more and more reasons to use and also believe in decentralized payment networks. Number five, we believe that global currency and financial infrastructure should be designed and governed as a public good. Now, once again, this is a very ambiguous statement. If you were to ask a series of dictators throughout history, I bet a few of them would have called acts of genocide a public good. And this is obviously not what people at Libra are planning to do, but one has to wonder, a public good for whom? In any financial system, there are winners and losers. The hope here is that Libra creates more of an even playing field, so to speak, than we have in the current based fiat systems. Moving on to number six, we believe that we all have a responsibility to help advance financial inclusion, support ethical actors, and continuously uphold the integrity of the ecosystem. Ethical actors is very vague, but financial inclusion is something we can all get behind. Free markets generate more wealth over time for the greatest number of people than any centralized planning model ever does. Now, if Libra is able to build a system that brings more people into the global economic fold, we could see millions of people pulled out of poverty in a good hurry. Many thanks for tuning into part one of our series about Libra. Now, there are still two more parts to go with much more information on how Libra will actually work and also the companies involved and much more about this very exciting project. So make sure you share and also subscribe so you don't miss out on the next two parts of the series. If you have any questions at all, please just drop them in the comments section below. For Crypto Global News, I'm Edward. Until next time, you take it easy.